Writing a resume with no job experience is easy, you'd say after watching this video. We'll break down each section and give you our top tips so you can follow along. Now, the sections you'll need for your resume are the header, experience, education, skills, and interests. So let's get started. Hi everyone, this is Chloe from Resume Genius, and I know that trying to get your foot through your first career door is always a struggle. But the good news is you have a lot more content you can put on your resume than you think. The first step is to fill out your header at the top of your resume. This is easier if you use a pre-made resume template, but is also quite easy within Microsoft Word with just a few tweaks. Your header must include your first and last name, along with contact details such as your email or phone number. If you have a strong LinkedIn profile or personal website, they're also definitely worth placing in your header. But if you're applying to jobs in the US, don't add a photo because it could potentially lead to discrimination. When you're done with your header, make sure to double check your information because hiring managers will use it to get back to you about the next step of the application process. After that, you should compose your resume objective. This is a 2-4 sentence self-introduction and statement of purpose you include at the top of your resume. There are other types of resume introductions, but a resume objective is especially effective for more inexperienced job seekers because it allows you to highlight your interest in a specific role at a particular company. Remember that the resume objective is the first thing your hiring manager will see, so be sure to keep it short and snappy like our example on screen. Your first sentence should include your amount of relevant experiences and skills, but because you have no experience yet, you can list your degree instead. Your second sentence should elaborate a bit more on what makes you qualified for the job, like your academic achievements. And your third sentence should express your interest in the specific role at the company you're applying to. You can also cover what you hope to bring to the company as its newest employee, why you chose the company, or how your experiences match the job description. To write these three sentences better, check the job description and pick out keywords to include. If the job you're applying to mentions SEO tools and marketing strategies, put those words in like this. Recent college graduate with a bachelor's degree in marketing and former vice president of the UCLA Business Society. Seeking to enter the marketing industry by leveraging data analysis and technological proficiency. Dedicated worker aiming to increase Resume Genius's website traffic using SEO tools and product branding. Now follow your resume objective with either your education, skills, or experience section. Start with the section that makes you the strongest candidate for the specific position you're applying for. With no work experience, you can still fill out an experience section with a variety of things, such as coursework, internships, volunteering, projects, or even fundraising. Think back to anything you've done in school or outside of school that relates to the job that you want. Write these experiences down. Are any of them relevant? If so, include descriptions of them in your experience section. Just remember to not stuff your resume with unrelated information because it won't help you win over the hiring manager. Here's an example of the experience section on a recent graduate's resume. Start with the title of your experience, such as social media management intern. Underneath that, list the dates and durations in months because most of your relevant experiences up to this point will have lasted less than a year. Below that, include a few bullet points detailing your role and achievements. Maybe you created the post for the company's Instagram or used Google Analytics to track the number of people who visit your website. If you have concrete numbers showcasing your successes, such as increasing social media page followers by a certain percentage, that's even better. Now that you have the content down, list your experiences as if they were actual jobs. The fact that you take your coursework and experiences seriously shows that you meet opportunities with a good attitude and work ethic. I recommend a cause and effect format, such as designed a blog to increase brand awareness using Java and Python, and work with coursemates to create podcasts using Audacity. Doesn't it sound much better than just designed a blog? This effectively highlights what you did and what you achieved for the company in the process. Now that your experience section is ready, it's time for the fun part, the education section. Here you can get a little more creative because different schools have different extracurriculars, scoring systems, and academic-related achievements. Just like in your experience section, write down the name of the school you attended, along with the name of your degree and the years listed below. You can add both your high school and college if you had a high GPA in both, but normally you should just list your highest degree. The next step is to brainstorm things you've achieved that make you stand out from your classmates. These can include extracurriculars, Greek life, academic milestones, and honors. Were you on the dean's list? Were you offered a scholarship? Don't worry if you come up short, because there are endless number of things you can list under education. Now, as a rule of thumb, we recommend only including your GPA in your education section if it's above a 3.5. Underneath your GPA, start a coursework or courses section. Keep in mind that this doesn't mean listing down math class if you're applying to be a journalist. You should only choose relevant classes such as news writing or video editing. Now, a major's name such as business does not come close to encompassing all of the interesting topics and projects you've covered as a student. Note down projects, class scores, debate topics, and any events you've hosted. Similar to your experience section, expand on every educational bullet point. A few examples to go under your school's name could be member of the debate team 2019, competed with 6 different universities in the US and won the Bronze Cup, or A+ in business studies and chemistry. As long as you can explain how these experiences are relevant for the job you're applying for, it doesn't matter how long ago they were. If you have plenty of space to fill up, a good tip is to turn your relevant coursework into a bulleted list so each course is on its own line. Now on to the next section. As a recent graduate, you don't need formal work experience to have a strong resume skill section. Just through your coursework and extracurricular activities, you've likely accumulated an array of marketable skills. Try to include a good mix of both hard and soft skills throughout your resume. Hard skills are job-specific abilities or knowledge learned through education, hands-on experience, or training. Some valued hard skills for resumes include copywriting, cashier skills, language skills, patient care, civil engineering, and HTML. Usually the hard skills needed for a position are listed in the job description's requirements section. Now, soft skills are character traits that positively affect how you work and interact with others. They would be what you call people skills and are useful across all industries. Soft skills showcase more of how you are and learn as a person. Do you work well in a team? Are you adaptable? If your answers are yes, then you can include teamwork and adaptability in your resume. Some valued soft skills for resumes include decision-making, open-mindedness, conflict management, and public speaking. Choose a select few for both categories and write one line explaining them. For example, if you put down organizational skills, write something along the lines of kept projects on schedule through regular checkups and ensured that all team members were hitting targets. Language proficiency should also go under your skill section. Multiple languages can be useful in any situation because they can help you make a sale or build rapport with clients. Be sure to put an adjective such as intermediate, fluent, or native before the language to explain your proficiency to the hiring manager. For your final section, you can include any interests or hobbies at the bottom of your resume if there's still space to be filled up. This gives employers a better idea of what you're like outside of work, which will help them gauge your personality and character. Use this section to subtly add to your skills section by adding things that fall under the soft skills category. For example, putting down basketball means that you're used to working with other people and therefore have teamwork skills. Just make sure that your interests or hobbies don't paint you in a negative light. Listing a hobby that divulges political or religious affiliations can be risky if it clashes with the company's beliefs. Some great interests to add, if they apply to you, are outdoor activities, art, travel, blogging, music, and gaming. Note that these all translate to other skills such as creativity, problem solving, and open-mindedness. And that's it! The hard part of writing your resume's content is over. But having great content isn't the last step because you'll still need a snazzy resume design to match. Now we've got you covered with a link to our free resume templates and a variety of other resources in the description box below. Simply download the design that you like, fill it in, and you'll have a winning resume ready to go. And if you found this video useful, remember to share and hit the like button below. Got top tips for job seekers with no experience, or have questions for our team of certified professional resume writers? Leave a comment below. Best of luck from the Resume Genius team, and we'll see you in our next video.